Hello, boys and girls. I'm so glad you're back this morning with Mrs. Waters, and we're at Nativity Faith Formation Center and doing our lesson for the primary grades today, Growing in Grace. And boys and girls, you know, last week we had such a special visitor. Our pastor, Father Tapp, came, and he reminded us of all of the beautiful traditions that we have going on for Ash Wednesday and Lent. Well, we have now moved past Ash Wednesday and went to church, of course, got our ashes. Maybe some of us streamed it and couldn't get our ashes, but that's okay. But boys and girls, now we are officially going to celebrate the first Sunday of Lent today. And I want to explain to you that the gospel that they have in our Mass for this particular week is one we've talked about already. And it's Jesus being out in the desert for 40 days. And you remember, the devil was right there tempting him the whole time. So we have already heard that story. And so Mrs. Waters would like instead to read you one of the other two readings that we do at Mass. There are two readings each week with our gospel. Now, I told you the gospel a long time ago. You might not remember this, but it comes from the Bible, but it's the New Testament. And the Bible in the New Testament tells all about Jesus's life. Well, when we go to the readings, they're also from the Bible, but they are from the Old Testament. And boys and girls, these are all of the years leading up to when Jesus was born. And these are the books of the Bible written by prophets and historians. And this is where we learn a lot about the prediction, the promise that Jesus is coming. Now, I'm really excited because today the reading that I will be telling you is from the very first book of the Bible, and it's called Genesis. Now, boys and girls, you know that Jesus was in the desert for 40 days. I think you'll remember that last week Father Tapp told us that Lent is 40 days. Wow, that number 40 must be really important in the Bible and in our religion. Well, today, the story I have to tell you also has the number 40 in it. And you will see how important that is to the reading from Genesis. So let's begin today by, I think we're gonna review just a bit about Lent and where we are on the path. And you know that we have a tree behind us that has all of these beautiful hearts on it. And these are all part of the new traditions that we're gonna put in place for Lent. We said that during Lent, we will pray. We will fast, which means not eating as much as we normally do, giving something up. We will maybe give an action up rather than food. And then last of all, the almsgiving. And boys and girls, Father Tapp explained to us that that is giving something to the needy. So we've got all of this going on, and I can't wait to fill this up with all of your hearts of all of the different items that you're gonna be doing during Lent to grow closer to God, to build your faith. And look what I have. I have a big giant one because I gave up a big giant something for Lent. And I'm gonna write it on here. And it's a hard one for me. Uh-oh. It says no TV. Boys and girls, all day long I'm home or I'm doing jobs or I'm running around. But after I make dinner and do the dishes, I love to go in and watch TV. And Mrs. Waters' favorite programs, the cooking shows. I'm always watching cooking shows and getting new recipes, but my husband and I are gonna have to stick with the old recipes for Lent because there will be no TV for me during Lent. Oh, pray for me on this one because it's gonna be hard. So boys and girls, we said, first of all, the colors from the liturgical calendar changed this beautiful purple during Lent. And the church gets real quiet. We don't say the Alleluia. We don't say the Gloria. Boys and girls, the priests will wear their purple garments. And it's a time for us to be quiet and reflect and get ready for the royalty of Jesus Christ, our Savior, and his journey through Lent. Boys and girls, we also talked about how we have 40 days in Lent to do something for the needy. And today we're going to do a little craft project, and the homework that I will give you today has something to do with 40 days of giving to the needy. So we'll talk about that later. But right now I'd like to start us in prayer, and we're going to move right on to our reading. So let's begin. Settle down, get comfortable. Hopefully you're in the same seat that you always sit in with your prayer cloth by you. And let's get ready to call the Holy Spirit in to help us pray wonderful prayers to our Lord during this time of Lent. Take that deep breath and begin in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Loving Father, thank you so much for giving us the Bible so that we can learn all of Jesus's actions, his loving, his giving, and most of all, the journey that he traveled in Lent, which leads us to Easter. And loving Father, thank you so much for giving us your son Jesus as a human being on this earth to teach us how to live. Boys and girls are going to try very, very hard to be closer to you during these next 40 days. And loving Father, please show them that you have your loving arms wrapped around them and that you're with them every single day. And they're going to be so excited to know that you're right there. And we are going to end in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Boys and girls, I am now going to read from the book of Genesis. And as I said, this is a reading that will be in our Mass this week. Well, God said to Noah and to his sons also, "See, I am now establishing my covenant." Boys and girls, that means a promise. "I am now establishing my covenant with you and your descendants. After you and with every living creature that was with you, all the birds and the various tame and wild animals that were with you and came out of the ark." The ark? We'll talk about that after the reading. "I will establish my covenant with you that never again, never shall all bodily creatures be destroyed by the waters of a flood. There shall not be another flood to devastate the earth." And then God added, "This is the sign that I am giving you." And if my camera could come over here to the sign that God gave to Noah. "This is the sign that I am giving you, which is the covenant between you and me and every living creature. I set my bow, my rainbow, in the clouds. I will recall the covenant that I have made between me and you and all living things, that when I bring clouds to cover the earth, the bow will appear in the clouds. And you shall know that the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all mortal beings." The word of the Lord. And boys and girls, we end with thanks be to God. That's what we do in Mass when we have a reading. We end with thanks be to God. This reading is the ending of a story that I'm going to tell you right now. The earth and all of the people on it were crazy, crazy, crazy. They were doing all kinds of bad things. They were not listening to God. They were just doing whatever the devil told them to do. And you know that devil? He lies. He doesn't tell the truth, and he gets us in trouble all the time. Well, the devil was wildly crazy with all these people, and they were bad. They were not doing the things that God wanted them to do. He tried to warn them. He tried to have talks with them. They wouldn't listen. They just kept on doing, and God had it. And so he knew that there was one really, really good man on earth named Noah. And he knew that if he went to Noah and had a talk with him, that Noah would listen. So when he went to talk to Noah, he said, first of all, I want you to build an ark. An ark is a huge boat. And Noah, when this ark is built, and I'm going to give you all the measurements and what to make it out of and whatever. When this ark is built, it's going to have three levels to it. And I want you to go out and collect two of every animal that's on the earth. And I want you to get your family, and I want you to climb up into the ark and close the doors. Because Noah, that's where you and your family and all of the animals will be safe when it starts to rain. Well, Noah didn't ask any questions at all. He knew that God would help him through this project. Now, I want you to think about this. This ark, this boat, has to hold two of every animal in the world. Oh my goodness, that would have to be like about as big as a football field. And it was. And boys and girls, after it was built, and let me tell you, Noah's neighbors thought he was crazy. Oh, look at that guy. He's building a boat. What does he think? He's crazy. Well, Noah then went to get two of every animal in the world. Now, boys and girls, when you think about animals, you not only think about pets, but you think about things like birds. Did you ever try to catch a bird? Do you think Noah had an easy time doing this? Can you imagine how much he loved trying to catch a snake? Oh, or a ladybug. Boys and girls, every animal in the world, he had to bring two of them to the ark. And one was a man and one was a woman, a male and a female, that he brought onto the ark. And boys and girls, when he had collected two of every single animal, he and his family climbed on board the ark and he closed the doors. And down on the bottom level is probably where the waters were and the fish were. And then probably in the middle, that's where the bigger animals were. And then up on the third floor is probably where the smaller animals and Noah and his family were. And all of a sudden, it started raining. All right, I'm going to ask a question. And if you think about this for a minute, I think you might remember a number that is very important in the Bible, because it rained for that many days. Do you have any guesses? How many days was Jesus in the desert? How long is Lent? And how many days did it rain when Noah was on the ark? Well, you know, if you guessed 40, you're correct. Now, boys and girls, we are in the month of February right now. And the month of February is a little bit different because it only has 28 days. But think about one whole month of 28 days, and it rained every day and every night and every day and every night. Boys and girls, all of a sudden, the water started to get deep on the land, and it rained for 40, not 28. So this rain, which kept up for 40 days, caused what we call a flood. And the water covered every single thing on earth. And the only thing living was on the ark, two of each animal and Noah and his family. And on the 40th day, the rain stopped. And Noah and his family were so thankful. They were safe, they were in the ark, and the rain had stopped. So Noah, after a while, started sending out birds to see if they could land anywhere or bring back something that they had found other than just water. But it took a long time for those floodwaters to go down. In fact, Noah and the animals were on that ark for 150 days until a beautiful dove flew off into the world. And when he came back, he had a branch in his mouth, which told Noah a tree or a bush was growing on the earth and they could come out of the ark. And that's when God said to Noah, I am making a promise to you. What did we say that promise was called? We said it was called a covenant. I'm making a covenant with you that I will never send 40 days of rain or a great flood ever again. And every time you see the rainbow, you will be reminded of my promise to you. Boys and girls, that was such a beautiful story. Except the fact that all of the evil people are gone. And the world started all over again, loving and worshiping God. And that's what we want to do during Lent. We want to start over. We want to be a new person, trying very hard to pray every day to God and to do His will. So boys and girls, that is our story from the Bible today. And we're going to do a little craft right now. And it has to do with the animals that were on the boat, one animal in particular. And the craft that we're going to do today is called origami. And origami is plain paper. And you fold it. And today we're going to fold it into an animal. So I would like you sometime this week, and the sooner you do it, the better. I would like you to find a plain sheet of white paper. And if your mom and dad have a printer at home, I'm sure you'll find white paper in there. But you take this piece of white paper, and I'm going to ask you to fold it so that it is a perfect square. And to do that, you just bring two edges together to match each other. So this is what the paper looked like. You fold from the bottom corner and it folds into a perfect square, and then you take a pair of scissors and you're going to cut this extra part off. Mrs. Waters likes bringing easy arts and crafts projects for you to do. You see, we now have a fold down the middle of our square, but I'm holding it up like a diamond. And what I would like you to do after you have this fold is to bring this first side over to the fold, line it up with the fold, and now you're going to fold this. All right? Then you're going to bring the second side over and line it up with the fold. And I'm going to put this on the table to do that since I didn't do very good on the first side. Move this just a little bit. So now we have something that looks like a kite. Do you see that? We folded our two sides in. Now what we're going to do is turn it over, put it down on the table, and once again, we're going to fold this side into the fold. So let's go ahead and do that. And when we're done, we're going to fold the second side into the middle. Let's do that. And boys and girls, you will see that we now have a very long and skinny kite, okay? We have a fold on this side, we have a fold on this side. And what I'd like you to do is go back to that second side, put it down on the table, and just take your narrow point and fold it up towards the top. Up towards the top, and then we're going to take the skinniest part and fold it down. We're going to fold it down. And boys and girls, when you pull this back up, you are going to have a swan. You have just made a swan, one of God's animals, out of paper in an art and craft form called origami. And I'm going to paint this little nose black. And I'm gonna give this one two little eyes because swans are very famous for being black and white and beautiful. All right, so boys and girls, we have a swan. And now for your homework. I would like you to make a swan. In fact, as you practice, you might make 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 20 swans. Because, boys and girls, it's really hard for us sometimes to come up with an idea for almsgiving. And today, Mrs. Waters would like to encourage you to write a little message on your swan. And I want you to give it to someone that you would normally not give a note to. And the first person that I think of is the person that delivers your mail every day. You could write, "Thank you," on the swan, put it out in your mailbox. You don't even have to be there when the mailman comes, and they will get a beautiful thank you from you, and make sure you sign your name because you want them to know it's from you. There are so many people that you could actually do this for. Think about it. If you ever go to the grocery with mom or dad, you could give one to the person that bags your groceries. It would say, "Thanks, you'd be with mom and dad. There's nothing dangerous about doing this, but you are giving someone some love at the grocery store that probably doesn't get a lot of love very often. Let's think of who else. I wrote down things at school. Think about the people at school that you could give it to. First thought I have is your media specialist. If you go to school, the media specialist doesn't ever have a whole class that's just theirs. You could take a thank you to them, and I know they would love it. How about one of the office workers? Or how about someone in the cafeteria? Those are people that don't get thanked very often. That would be a beautiful way of almsgiving. Another idea I had was, how about a coach? How often do you actually give your coach a card that says thank you? Well, today you could make a beautiful swan for your coach to say thank you. So your homework this week, boys and girls, is to make as many swans as you care to and write your beautiful little note on there. Maybe you don't want to say thank you. Maybe you want to say, "I love you," or "You're the best." You can put any message that you so desire. But this week, boys and girls, your homework is to at least give out one swan with love in it. And I think that's a pretty easy assignment. So let's review what we talked about. We talked about 40 days in the desert, 40 days of rain on Noah's ship called the Ark, and now 40 days of Lent. We talked about praying. We talked about fasting. And now Mrs. Waters is asking you to do almsgiving. Today, when we close our lesson, I'm going to think about 5 animals that I want to pray for. And I want you to think about your favorite 5 animals. And I would love you to pray for them. And boys and girls, the love that God gives us to share with others doesn't only go to human beings. It can go to our loved pets. It could go to the birds that fly by. Oh, those butterflies, it makes me just want to smile when I see them. So boys and girls, today, you know I have a little wiener dog at home called Tinkerbell. This is going to be one of my 5 animals. I love hummingbirds, and I have them in my yard. That's going to be my 2nd animal. I love turtles. My 1 daughter used to be nicknamed Turtle, and so this is a very special animal for me. This flamingo reminds me of Florida, and every time I see one, I thank God for saving the flamingo on the Ark so we could have them here in Florida. That's 4, and boys and girls, my last one is a snake. And the reason why I wanted to pick this snake is because so many people are afraid of snakes. And a lot of times we think of the devil as a snake or the snake is a devil. But today I want you to pray for the snakes because they too are creatures of God. So let's begin our final prayer. And once again, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And loving Father, I am going to ask for special prayers this week for wiener dogs, hummingbirds, turtles, flamingos, I almost forgot, and snakes. And loving Father, thank you for putting them on this earth with all of the beautiful flowers and all of the wonderful trees and all of the loving people. And Father, we ask you to keep us all in your loving care this week. And we end in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Don't forget, I want to put your heart up on this tree. Pam@nativitycatholicchurch.org. It's in the bulletin. It's online. Make sure you send me your hearts. I want to know what you're giving up. And pray for me this week as I don't do TV for the next 40 days. Boys and girls, have a very blessed week.